Welcome everyone, Farmer Cop here. This is going to be a new mod map tour of Calmsden Farm. This is by Oxygen David. I'm going to read what the description says in the mod hub. I think you guys are going to be blown away by this map. First off, a couple things as we get into it. I apologize for not posting so much recently. I know a lot of you guys probably saw my community post. My grandfather passed away, unfortunately, this last week. So I've been spending time with family and taking a little bit of a break. But I did see this map got released, and I was very excited to hop on it, so I figured this would be a good way to kind of start easing back into getting some content out to you guys, and I do miss posting and playing the game, so I know you guys will say take as much time as you need, and I am doing that. Don't worry, I'm not trying to rush back into anything, but I also miss recording and being with you guys. So we're going to jump into it, but let's go ahead and read what the description is in the mod hub. It says, welcome to Calmsden Farm. This map is based in Gloucestershire, UK. I probably will say some things wrong. I apologize. It says, replica of the real-life farm and surroundings, real-life PDA map, custom lighting XML with deeper blue sky and darker nights, animations such as birds flying across the map, pedestrians, etc., custom textures with parallax mapping, over 50 HD new models made by Oxygen David himself, 36 fields with missions, small, medium, and huge, two placeable areas where you can build your own productions or farm, five sell points in BGA sawmill, etc., seasons visuals, summer barbecues, mowers, washing lines, etc., autumn fallen leaves from trees, winter snowmen, icicles, and many more. Collectibles are on this map, UK license plates built into the map, custom grass textures, and loads of custom sounds. I hope you all like this map. This is, again, by Oxygen David, 560.84 megabytes to download. This is for all platforms, and it is a very awesome map. So we're going to go and jump into it. I do have my audio on. I don't have any speakers with me, so as I am recording from Montana, I am using my desktop, though. I did bring it. So I do have my desktop, which makes it a little strange to have it here with me, but we're going to go ahead and just walk around the map. You do start off with a dog there. And actually we'll go ahead and start off looking at some of the equipment we have, here. Let's go ahead and do that. So I can't hear anything that's going on, but you guys should be able to hear stuff. So if we go down to our garage, medium tractors, we have a John Deere or two 6230Rs. We have, also a Fendt 714 Vario. We have a harvester here, big old Trion 720 there for us. We have a telehandler JCB. Small trailer, header for our, Trion cultivator there for us. We also have a direct drill seeder, a roller there, the Power Roll 1230 HD. We have a nice big old sprayer there, the Vantage 4300. We have a mower. We have a baler. We have some different telehandler tools there. We have a bale fork, pallet fork, and universal bucket. We also have a header trailer for our header. And we got a white there, so that's what we own starting out. Again, we do have a dog, as I mentioned. This is where you start off when you load into the map, and the collectible right there. Nine more water trailers to be found, and then I don't know how many collectibles are on this map. 100, so you got plenty of collectibles on this map. The visuals on this map are absolutely incredible. This map looks amazing. So as you walk around, you'll see a lot of that. So you do have, if you go around here, a sleep trigger. So we have a sleep trigger here at our house. And if we go into the map, actually, as we get started here, sorry, I'm not used to doing map tours yet because we only had, this is our second map out. Gosh, my mouse is not wanting to, there we go, not wanting to zoom out more. Hate this mouse, I need to get a new one. All right, there we go. So we have, I love the setup here, just the way it's sitting on a table like. And this is where we start off right here, our farmhouse is right there. If we go in here, what we own, so we have all this kind of peripheral area. If I can click on it, I don't think you can sell it, actually. Yeah, you own it, but you can't sell it. You can sell off all your other little fields and surrounding areas through here. A little area there to sell. Lots of little chunks of land that you own, and then field prices kind of vary. This is one big placeable area here. Another one's way up here. And again, we'll take a look at those as we go around. We're probably going to walk around all of this area here. We have our kind of our starting farm just up the road here, another farm here, and some animal pens or pastures out here. And then we'll probably actually end up flying around to all these other various locations just to kind of help speed things up. I try to keep my map tours relatively short just so it's not, you know, I just want to get you guys kind of a feel of the map without wasting too much of your time. We do have a nice forestry area here. This is actually a big grass pasture in the middle of here. Not a pasture, I should say. A big grass field in the middle of these trees here. But yeah, we got lots of sell points dotted around the map, which we'll take a look at. So let's go ahead. And again, we own both of these kind of starting farm areas here, field 15 there and all that good stuff. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and walk out. We'll probably take a look at these animals and head over to the farms. So if we go, actually, yeah, we're gonna head this way. I think this will be, you know what, actually we'll go this way. We'll go out the front of the house. It just kind of makes a little bit more sense. We'll go out this way, and there's so many details, and again, I can't stop and point them all out because we'll be here all day. And why don't you go look at the farms first? There's deer on the road. I love it. Fantastic. But yeah, if we head up here, I'll give us a little bit more speed as we're going. Let me get up to here. So here's our first kind of farm area. Again, you got a fuel tank here. If we go over here, we have cow pasture. Gonna hold 150 cows. Oop, not flashlight on. Got a silo right here. You can open it up to go ahead and dump stuff in. Then we got a, I believe this is a water tank here. And this, I believe, is where you get the milk out for your cows. Storage facilities for us. So we got some telehandler tools in here. And I will miss stuff on this map, so be aware of that. There's a lot going on. But I just want to give you guys a general overview of it. And I wanted to hop on here because it just looks... Just the detail is amazing. Everything just looks so, so crisp. It almost hurts my eyes to look at it because it's so, so well done. We walk around this way. Got a bunker silo right here. I believe it's a bunker silo. Yep, bunker silo right there for us. And then in here, we got our dump area for the food for the cows. And open this gate up. A lot of the gates open up and everything. There's deer in our pasture out here. You can get your slurry from here. Big old area here. You can mow or do whatever you wanted to do. It's a big field. And then, yeah, pretty cool. A little water trough out there. I don't think you can put water in it, but it's out there. Then we got some tractors and stuff. Some of our equipment's parked out here in this shed. But yeah, this is kind of that farm there. So we're going to head up to the other one. Let's cruise along the road here a little bit. So back down this way. And again, a lot of the gates will open up. I'm not sure if this one will or not. Nope, this one. Oh, that one does open. There we go. Just had to give it a second. We'll head up. So that's where we started. Our farmhouse is right there. We'll head up the road a little bit further. And as we go up here, you can see we have animal pens again, kind of on the side. This is our sheep pasture. 200 sheep there for you. We'll take a look at the pastures here in a second. But as we go up, we have kind of our second farmyard area here. And again, we have a liquid fertilizer tank right here for us. Plenty of storage. You got some of our stuff stored around here. As we walk around this way, maybe I'll open this stuff up here. Yep, lots of stuff in here for us. And a lot of the stuff will have lights and stuff. So we go there. You got, potentially you have lights you can turn on. If I can get them to work. Yeah, turn on shed lights. Oh, it's R. That's right, I forgot. They changed. I'm just here clicking. But that makes sense. It's changed with the 22. Another silo here. And the endpoint for this silo, I believe, is around the corner. I remember correctly. I actually watched Farm Sim Snowy's map tour of this last night before I went to bed, just because I wanted to take a look at the map. But yeah, here you go, right here. So big shout out to Farm Sim Snowy for that. Make sure you guys check out his channel if you have not. He does console map tours and different console content. You do have a repair trigger in here, a little tight to get into, but if I can get actually over the trigger, there we go. But you do have a repair trigger, so which is very nice to have. And then that is pretty much this whole farm area through here. So we have this whole farm here. Now, if we take a look, what we're going to do is we're going to walk down this way, and we're going to take a look at some of these pastures we have around here, because, again, we have sheep pasture, which we already looked at one of the entrances for there. Remove junk and barns. We'll take a look at that in a second. It's pretty cool, kind of that feature there. And then we have horse barn, chicken pasture, and a pig pasture there. So we'll go and take a look at all that stuff here. Cruise down this way. Again, sheep pasture there. Took a look at that already. We'll head up this way. This nice little path through here. I don't need to go that fast, huh? All right, it's a little quick, but go out into here if we'd like to. Here's the junk here. So junk and barn. So we have all this. This will open up here for you so you can kind of access it through there. We have all of this stuff kind of in these barns here. All stuff to kind of take a look at. But you can remove all of this if you'd like to. If you go into the build screen here, you can click on it and you can sell it. It does take money, but if you sell it, it removes all of that junk from out there. So you have now some nice storage areas. So you want to do that? Pretty cool. I think that's a cool feature. And we have our chickens right here, I believe. Why am I not? Maybe it should work for me. Do we not own this? That might actually be the case. No, we should. Oh, maybe we don't own this. Where am I at? Let's try if we go into here and we buy this little chunk of land. Let's see if that fixes our problem. Nope. I might be just in the wrong spot too. So Ignore me trying to figure this out. Maybe I have to go a little bit further. Here we go. Open dialogue. There, I guess I gotta go on this side of it. So not quite over where it's at, but big horse training area here. We have the horse barn over there. And then we also have, again, we got some other pastures. This is our sheep pasture here. And then up above, I believe this is cows up here. Up over the fence. Or pigs up here, that's right. Yeah, pig pasture, horses, that's right. There's no cows over here. We did have cows down over there. So, yeah, so very cool. That's kind of this central area where kind of the town type area is. But there's all the sell points are kind of on the peripheral. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to fly over those areas. A lot of people ask me what this mod is I'm using right here to do flight mode and stuff like that. This is the Power Tools mod, which allows you to do flight mode and stuff like that. And then I'm hitting B and V to speed up my speed of my person themselves. So I can speed them up. And that is through a mod called Player Speed. Oh, and also, so this area here, this tree area. Go down. Huge open grass area in the middle here. I'm not sure how you would access it, because I think it's fenced off most of the way. But there's, oh, right there. You can come in through there probably and drive around. Coming through here probably and get into there. Yeah, so there's different ways to get into there. But yeah, very cool. They have an open area there. Now we head out to the edge of the map. You can see this map is just beautiful. I love the layout. It's, again, based on a real-life area. It's going to save my content real quick. Based on a real-life area. So, yeah, it's just very cool. But we'll go out here. We'll take a look at this stuff. And then I think we'll work our way clockwise around and finish up down here at the bottom. So right up here, what we have here is we have a lime station in the garden center. So that's what we're going to stop at first, which is just out here. Let's get out here. Got, again, your lime station right there. And then you got your garden center sell point. Now, I used to, in the old game, I'd come in here and I would take a look at what everything sold because I'd find it by... you know, by whatever the case may be, but I can't really do that with the way it's laid out. I have to go through every single one, which what I might do, I mean, I can just scroll through here nice, and there's no place to take oats, it looks like, but I'll just kind of scroll through just kind of quickly here. So if you wanted to see what things were taken at different sell points and stuff like that, you could just pause the video if you were curious what something was, or if something was taken at a specific sell point. So that's probably what I'll do in the future as far as map tours go. I just kind of scroll through kind of just like this. And if you wanted to skip this, you can just skip ahead a few points here if you wanted to not know where anything was sold or anything like that, or you didn't care about this portion. So feel free to do that, obviously. But yeah, there's just kind of a quick overview of where things are taken at different spots. But there you go. This is the garden center. There's someone walking around doing their thing. And again, the detail on this place is just incredible. It does look like a legit garden center. So there we go. Now we want to go clockwise, don't we? So head up here. And you can see the edge of the map. And then even stuff like this. A nice little walking trail through here. Like, I just love that. Just the detail. Just the detail. Build 24 just below us. We'll head out here. That's our farms we can see in there. Pastures through there. We can see all that stuff off in the distance. Then up over here, we have several sell points. So coming from this side here, if we take a look at the map, we're up over here. So we have the general store, bale sell point. So general store is right here. General store bale sell point is here. And then as we move over here, we have some more stuff going on. You can see we have the general store bay one, which is right there. So you can sell inside of there. And then we also have the sawmill right here. So sawmill area here. And again, you can buy this as a production facility. If we go up to the wrench, I should be able to hit R. May not let me do it. Oh, there we go. So it's $100,000 to purchase the sawmill as a production point. And you also, I believe, when you start out, you own the BGA as a production point already. So I think if we go down to our productions, yep, we own the BGA. So you already own that as far as when you start out in this map. And I am in new farmer mode. I didn't mention that. I should mention that. I'm in new farmer mode. So if you don't start new farmer mode, you usually don't start with all the equipment and land and stuff like that. But there we go. So we'll continue around the map, get a good view. I love the hot air balloons there. And also, too, this is one of the big placeable areas here. So you have this big area here if you wanted to place stuff on it. Big open area. That's one of the ones up there if we look at the map. This guy right here. And then again, we also have this one down here, which we'll take a look at once we get down there. They're very cool. And I love the signage that you have to let or for sale signs. Development land, 11.3 acres. I love it. Very cool to have that on there. But yeah, okay. Where are we at? We are up over... right there. Okay, we're just going to cut just over this way here. Or not that way. Sorry, down this way. Getting all mixed up here. All right, and what do we have here as we come in? We got all sorts of stuff. So you can see just inside we have the farm store. Bay 2 right there, and then that far one is going to be the farm store Bay 1 right there. And then as you look over here, we have another sell point, which is going to be your farm store Bale sell point right there. And then we have our selling station for vehicles, so you can sell your vehicles over here. This is the vehicle shop. And then we have the actual store icon right there. So we have that vehicle shop and vehicle selling station there. So there we go. We'll continue to work around the map. We're stuck. There we go. Out of the way there. Nice detail on the map. I love it. Come down here. Nice open grass areas through here on the hills. We're stuck again. There we go. Nice little stream that works its way through the land, which is pretty nifty. We got another field here, and then this kind of works our way over towards the BGA, which is right here. So we have the BGA here, and then we have big open area. This is your second placeable area here. So again, BGA should have just BGA type stuff here. So debris crusher is also here as well. And we also have, actually looks like, some sell points in here. So yeah, just on the other side. So the debris crusher, that's the BGA there. The debris crusher, where is that at? Right under there. By debris crusher LTD. And then we have that guy, which was, what did we say it was? That was the Cotswold Stores Bale sell point. And we have Cotswolds Stores, which we'll tag that real quick right there. And then lastly, down here, we have the farmer's market right there. I believe that's, yeah, those are the three different spots we wanted to take a look at there. So we can go ahead and, if we can click that, untag that. So sell points down here. And then our final stop on the trip to Almsden Farm is going to be just over this way. And here we are, our final stop here. Down here, we have the animal dealer located just over this way, right off the road there. And we have just below it, we have, oops, if I can click it, the farmer's market right there. I like the look of that farmer's market. Then we have the Allsphere store and Allsphere store bale sell point. So that's those two back here. But yeah, very cool map. Very well done by Action David. I did not think we'd see this map this soon. And I did not expect it to, I'm not surprised it came out for all platforms, I guess. I was a little worried it might not because of how much detail's in it, but. Oh, and another cool feature, I mean, there's so many cool features on this map. You guys will comment down below, I'm sure, a ton that I missed, but if we go to the river, we should be able to find some moving fish, which is just blows me away. Lower ourselves down a little bit. We should be able to find some moving fish somewhere along here. Just look a little bit. Be able to find some swimming fish. No? Oh, there we are. That's so cool. That's just extra detail that did not have to be there. That is there. So cool. Well, anyhow, guys, on that note, that is my map tour for this. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please drop a like down below. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button up on the screen to join the Farmer Cop channel and turn your notification bell so you don't miss any future videos I may post. This has been Farmer Cop. Thank you guys for coming and for watching.